Hello and welcome back to the channel. So in the previous lecture, we have seen all about the Apache Spark and we have executed our first Spark application on top of Hadoop cluster. So Spark was nothing but a processing engine to process huge number of data on top of our Hadoop cluster. So in this lecture, we are going to talk about Apache Pig, which is used for analyzing large data set. So without further ado, let's get into it. So you may ask, what really is Apache Pig and why do we need it? We have many other options like Hive, Spark, as well as MapReduce itself. So this lecture, you'll get a clear idea why we can use Apache Pig to process our data. So Pig is nothing but a programming language which can run on top of Hadoop, or else it can run on a standalone basis, which is nothing but a tool for analyzing large data set. And it uses a language known as Pig Latin, which is a scripting language used for processing either structured, semi-structured or unstructured data as well. And it can use Hadoop for resource allocation as well as the storage layer. So it uses YARN for resource allocation and HDFS for storing the data. So as I have said, it uses the Pig Latin, which provides various operators. So it is just like a SQL language. So if you're familiar with SQL, this is pretty much very easy to understand for you. So to analyze data in Apache Pig, so we need to write script using Pig Latin language and you can execute it on our Hadoop cluster as well. So on the higher level, it will just convert that Pig script into the MapReduce job, in which our program will be converted into mapper and reducer programs, and it will be executed parallelly across our cluster. So as you already familiar with the MapReduce, we don't need to discuss that in detail. But Apache Pig is just like Hive, but Hive is more or like used for processing structured data, which is in form of tables, just like RDBMS. And it is also similar to a database system. But coming to Apache Pig, it is more versatile tool and it can handle structured as well as semi-structured data as well. But wait a minute, we have other processing languages. So why we need it actually? That we will discuss now. So basically, the major selling point for Apache Pig is ease of programming. So what does it mean really? So the developers who are not good in Java will normally struggle working MapReduce jobs for processing the data on Hadoop. Because as you already know, MapReduce jobs are majorly written in Java and it could be very complex. So certain small operations can become several lines of code, which is not that efficient for every developer. So if you go for Apache Pig, that Pig Latin language is very simple to understand. The second point is obvious. So if you work with SQL, it will be very easy to learn Pig, because after all, Pig is also a scripting language and the syntax is pretty much similar to the SQL, which we have discussed in our Hive tutorial. The next one is, it offers built-in operators for supporting many transformations such as joins, filters, order by, etc. So just like SQL, we can either join two or more data sets as well as apply filters to it and use order by for sorting out the data. So it comes in handy if you're dealing with structured as well as semi-structured data. And the last and most important, you don't have to write complex mappers and reducer functions. So it will save you a lot of time. So as a developer, you can focus on optimization opportunities, which is way more important if you're dealing with huge number of data sets. So this was all about why we need the Apache Pig. But you may ask, where does it actually sits on our Hadoop ecosystem? So let's discuss about that. So as you can see in this representation, Apache Pig is nothing but a scripting tool which sits on top of MapReduce. So what it does is, if you submit your Pig script on Hadoop cluster, it will just convert it into the MapReduce job, where the mappers and reducer functions will work to provide the solution and process your data. And it will use YARN as a resource allocator. So it will communicate with your name nodes and data nodes simultaneously to get the info of where the data resides and how to process it. It plans and submits those parallelly to get the benefit of parallel processing of the distributed computing. So it can also make use of Tez execution engine. So you may remember when we discuss in Hive, there was one execution engine which can be an option for MapReduce. So test engine will take the advantage of the DAG, which is direct acyclic graph. So rather than making it a linear process like mappers and reducers, it will find the most optimal way by finding the correlation between all the tasks which needs to be executed parallelly, and it can give you up to 10 times faster execution than MapReduce. So what it is actually, that we will see in our upcoming lectures, and we'll also make a comparison between using MapReduce versus using Tez execution engine for both Hive and Pig, and we will see the difference and see the power of Tez. And you may also be aware that this DAG, which is direct acyclic graph, this concept is also used in Apache Spark for getting faster computation of your data. But simply said, Pig nothing but sits on top of MapReduce as well as Tez to process your data, so that Pig script will be converted into MapReduce or either the Tez job, which again computes the data on top of your Hadoop cluster by using the YARN as a resource allocator and the HDFS for storing the data. So this was pretty much all about where this Pig sits on our Hadoop ecosystem. So at the last, let's discuss about some key features of Apache Pig. So the first one is it processes many types of data. So what do I mean by that is it can handle all kinds of data such as structured, semi-structured, as well as the unstructured data, which is the key selling point for using the Apache Pig over the Hive, because Hive can only deal with the structured data, which is present in the form of table-like structure similar to the RDBMS. The next one is ease of programming. So you don't have to worry about writing long scripts, which is written in Java, which has the mappers and reducer function to it. You can just use the Pig Latin language, which is just like SQL, to process your data, and it can automatically convert it into the MapReduce job and submit it on the Hadoop cluster. So you don't have to worry about writing a big Java code. So if you're a SQL programmer, Pig Latin will be easy for you to understand. You will get more clear idea in our next lecture, where we will actually submit the Pig script on our Hadoop cluster. The next feature is extensibility. So it is the most interesting feature it has. So it means that we can use our own function for reading, processing and writing the data using the existing operators present in Apache Pig. The next one is it has the space for optimization. The benefit of working with Pig is the task optimize the executions automatically, so you don't have to worry about that, and we can only focus on the semantics of the language, and as you don't need to spend more time developing your code as it is very simple to use and will give you the ease of programming, there will be a space for optimization. And the last one is it has the variety of operators. So you can do all sorts of operations such as join, sort, filter, and many more. So if you are a SQL programmer, you can pretty much familiar with all sorts of operation. So you can two or more data sets, or either you can sort it with ascending or descending order. Otherwise, you can apply different sorts of filters. So it has variety of operators which make it easier to work with structured as well as semi-structured data. So these were all the main features of Apache Pig. So in the next lecture, we are going to write our first Pig script for processing our data which is stored in HDFS. And we will also try running the Pig on top of MapReduce, as well as we will compare it by running it on the Tez execution engine, and we'll find the most optimal way to process our data if you're dealing with Apache Pig. So if you like this lecture, please subscribe to our channel and also ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on our social media, which I have linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.